But pretty soon it'll be college football season, and I got this in front of me here, Jim. Preseason All Big Ten from Athlon Magazine. Their magazine will be coming out in the stands, I believe, in late June, early July. Look at Indiana. Mike Penix, first team. Micah McFadden, first team. Tywan Mullen, first team. Charles Campbell, first team. That's four first teamers. The kicker, Ty Freifogel, surprisingly on the second team.
Yeah, that just blew me up. That's ridiculous. That's absolutely ridiculous.
Well, I mean, but you got Olave. You got – I'm trying to think who else you have. There's another receiver that was pretty good.
Not a tight end, though.
Ty Freifogel, wide receiver, yeah. Peyton Hendershot, second team tight end. Jalen Williams, third team corner. Devin Matthews, third team safety. The newcomer, DJ Matthews, third team wide receiver and punt returner. And then Caleb Jones, offensive line, fourth team. But a bunch of guys there. That speaks to player development, because you look at a lot of those guys. Well, certainly Penix was a highly touted recruit, but McFadden, Ty Freifogel, Mullen was a highly touted recruit. But a lot of those guys were under the radar guys that Tom Allen and his staff have developed. So there's something to be said for that.
How surprised were you that Olave came back?
Yeah, very surprised. But he's a guy that, certainly will be a difference maker. I think Garrett Wilson is back too. That might've been the other first teamer. I mean, Ohio State, Ohio State, the big question will be at the quarterback position. You lose Justin Fields. I know they have good guys behind him, obviously, highly touted recruit, but you never know how those guys are going to react until, the bodies come flying at them. So I think there's some unknowns there. I mean, certainly the unknown for Indiana is can Mike A, start the season on time, which is looking very promising, but B, get through the full season healthy? And if not, can Jack Tuttle give you enough, the way he did certainly in the Wisconsin game, but then you follow that up with a little bit of a disappointing performance in the Ole Miss game and the bowl game, partly because he got he took a shot to his chops as well. Protecting the quarterback is going to be of paramount importance, as always. But I think Indiana's got, and Tom mentioned this in the spring too. I mean, you take a look at the offensive line, even Caleb Jones, Bedford, he's going on his third year starting. You've got Dylan Powell inside. And the newcomer, Zach Carpenter, who's pretty big for a center, right? 6'5", 320, and a former guy at Michigan. I think you've got a good offense. Luke Haggard showed a lot of progress last year. I think you got a pretty good and pretty deep offensive line. That's going to definitely be a strength to this team, and maybe it'll impact the run game as well a little bit too going forward. And I think with that, Dylan McCullough, and maybe more of a running back by committee approach, you could have a good run game as well to complement and to take heat off the quarterback a little bit.
Yeah, and everyone is saying, considering that Michael Penix, it's Michael Penix or bust for Indiana, and I don't believe that. I think that that's going to make it better, obviously. But Jack Tuttle is a more than a capable backup. I think he's a more capable backup this year than Peyton Ramsey. I think that he will be able to do more if, well, let's hope that that's not the case. But if it was, he has more ability than say a Peyton Ramsey. Peyton Ramsey was experienced, but. Jack Tuttle is not that far off. I think he showed in the Wisconsin game at Wisconsin what they can do. So was it Wisconsin I'm thinking about?
Yeah, I think the thing with what's interesting, though, is, I mean, you take a look over the last 2 years, they're 11-2 with Penix as a starter. And without him, I think they're 3-4, 3-5. I think that's kind of the thing about Mike is also, and listen, we've seen some games, Mike struggled certainly in that Maryland game, before he got hurt, even if you remember, he had that terrible first half, but Penn State, he wasn't necessarily great until the end of the game when he made the big plays, but there is a certain it factor about Mike, I think, that kind of rises all boats. And, you take a look at Ty Freifogel's numbers with Mike and without Mike. I mean, I think that was very telling. So I think there's something to be said for how the team responds to him as well. I think they rallied around Jack in that Wisconsin game, but for whatever reason, it didn't translate to the bowl game. But there were a lot of issues in the bowl game. I think one of the really unspoken issues in the bowl game too was the recovering from COVID and a lot of guys just not being in, you know, the same kind of football shape or the same kind of sharpness that you had before that. You remember you had the two postponements against Purdue at the end of the season. You really had that momentum, and that momentum was kind of quashed throughout that whole month of December because you had players shuttling in and out of practice too. So it kind of hit them at a bad time right before the bowl game. And then you face an Ole Miss team that, you know, you probably maybe even were a little overconfident, and they might have been dejected, Indiana, about not going to a New Year's Six Bowl too. There were a lot of factors, but hopefully this year, you know, you don't have those significant interruptions. You get a full season, and you see how it goes, and guys stay healthy and stay fresh throughout the year.